Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We've just been having a little chat to Yair Miller, the CEO of UIA New South Wales, and I've still got him here on Zoom because we've hardly even touched the surface, Yair.
Indeed.
And now we're going to continue with a profile and also a dedication to the new president of Israel. By the time this goes to air, he will definitely be the new president. And I think it's a very exciting, extremely fortuitous time for us.
It is. He's a remarkable man with a fantastic relationship with diaspora Jewry and Australian Jewry in particular. He's got a long history with our community. He's got a long history with the diaspora community, and he's got a long history with Keren Hayesod UIA. So we are indeed fortunate to have a man of his caliber and of his pedigree serving the people of Israel and the Jewish community worldwide.
70 years to the creation of this wondrous nation, this fantastic phoenix that got out of the ashes of the Holocaust, and with the greatness of the Zionist movement, there's so much to be proud of. So much to be proud of. And it was really a great Australian contribution that gave us a lot for our independence. I mentioned Doc Evatt constantly for a long time, and definitely in this visit, because Doc Evatt was there at the decision that Australia said yes. And not only that, he was the one who coordinated the results of the special committee that had to bring the resolution 181 to a vote. Now, Doc Evatt was a very close friend of my late uncle, Abba Iban, because Abba Iban, as you remember, was the first Israeli ambassador or emissary to the United Nations, and they had a huge affinity. And my late aunt Susie was a great lady in her own right. I can, as a personal story, a few years ago, I told her, Auntie, I'm meeting an Australian politician. His name is Abbott, Tony Abbott. She says, no, you mean Doc Evatt. In Hebrew, it's the same. So I always, that's how I remember the name Doc Evatt. And I read a lot, and I think that really Australia's contribution to the Zionist enterprise from 1917 onwards is something that we have to be really proud and appreciative of, and it symbolizes the unique relationship between our nations and the moral clarity of your leadership throughout as it pertains to Israel's independence, strength, and security. Dear friends, what is more befitting in the period of Bein HaMetzarim, between the fasts as we are aiming toward Tisha B'Av, than to discuss what Ahavat Chinam is all about? Free love, free respect, free cordiality, free honor between human beings. We as a nation are marking Tisha B'Av, but we tend to forget the day after what brought the downfall of the first temple and the second temple. Rak Sinat Chinam, only hate with no other reason, no logic behind it, no basis, nothing ideological. Believe me, it was pure hate between groups. This can recur in every generation. It can happen in any nations, and we are seeing it also in modern times. Now that we have our own nation state, the State of Israel, now that the Jewish people are so heavily challenged, while still succeeding in so many spheres, we must do whatever we can to lower the flames, to extend our hand, to get to know the other, to understand and listen to each other.
Words have tremendous power. Power to create realities and also to change it. Powers to destroy and also powers to rebuild. Powers that can ignite a fire capable of consuming an entire world of values. And then, as the poet Rabbi Shlomo Ibn Gabirol, one of the great spiritual giants of Sephardi Judaism, wrote, he who sows hatred will reap remorse. Therefore, these days, every leader must act responsibly, serving as a moderate and calming voice, to make sure to speak carefully, to ensure the freedom of expression and prevent at all costs freedom of instigation, and to remember the words of Yehuda Amichai, in this burning country, woods must bring shade. After all, the only ones who differentiate between us are ourselves. We see every difference, every facial feature, every color, every preference. Every excuse we have to distance ourselves from each other through arguing, fighting, and winning, but the missiles do not distinguish between us, nor does COVID-19, nor do our enemies or those who wish us harm. The silent tombstones and military cemeteries are uniform, as are the hospital scrubs of our doctors and nurses. We must stop seeing the differences between us as obstacles. They are indeed the source of our power. It is thanks to our differences that Israeli power can be revealed in full force. After all, we would not be who we are without the immense human and ideological diversity that we have, a mosaic that weaves together the Israeli sense of family, the resourcefulness, and the optimism. Together with the principles of justice and solidarity and compassion, all of which are the components of an exemplary society. Innovation and determination and the commitment to the task, the powers of creation and renewal which grant us the possibility of contact with the human infinity, as David Grossman put it so nicely. Therefore, I still believe in us. I believe it is possible, it is within reach. So let us choose every day anew in us. We shall choose to win together, not just to beat each other. We shall choose to brighten up faces, to put out fires and hatred with the Israeli spirit, to increase the love of Israel. We will choose to be united, not just in our values and principles, but also in our hopes and dreams. We will choose to heal for the rift that harms us, all of us, together. All that is said in the prayer of the State of Israel, composed by my grandfather, the late Rabbi Herzog: ordain peace in the land and grant its inhabitants eternal happiness. Let it be so. Long live the State of Israel.
A standing ovation for President Isaac Herzog, wrapping up his first address as Israel's 11th president. You can see him on your screen shaking hands there with his predecessor, President Reuven Rivlin, also next to Nikki Levy, the Speaker of Parliament, both of whom have also addressed the plenum, an historic moment in the history of the State of Israel.